Hey, this is Damon Nelson, and to do that same video that you saw me post on the DropMock design group, let me show you how I did it. First off, I went in and I put a green screen image inside a DropMock. So whenever it asked for the image, I just uploaded a 1280 by 720 green image, and it's all one color. And then underneath this, I'm using Camtasia. Underneath it is the actual video that I want to play through to it. And then in front of it, what I did was I did 1 second clips. I'll show you what they are. The first one here is this image. So I made this image in DropMock and I downloaded it. Then I went over here and I made a second image in DropMock and I downloaded it. And so I put both images inside of Camtasia and I made them 1 second apiece. So each of them are 1 second in duration.
So that's how you get the screen switching mode there for the first 4 seconds. And then the fifth second, I did that first video again. And this is where you have to use a little imagination. Is I have, this is the bottom frame. And then the top frame is this image right here. And so what I did was I created a visual animation. So that's what these little dots are. That's a keyframe animation. So what I did was I just clicked add animation and then I resized the DropMock image here, the first image, and I turned the Z axis, which you can turn like this. Back to where it was, and then you can turn the y-axis. So you just kind of have to play with it a little bit to get it to fit just right. And then to fine-tune it, you just hold the Alt key and you can kind of tune it up a little bit in there. You can change these axes here. And it's not ever going to be really just perfect. So don't worry about it just being absolutely perfect. I'm spinning on the y-axis there. Okay, that's about as close as I'm going to get. Then what you do is you put another animation right here. And basically you expand it to full size and take out, zero all this back out. And so what I did was this image right here is I just made it full size and lined it all up. And then I immediately dropped it into the actual green screen itself. And I'm going to turn off this temporarily so you can see. This is what I actually made in DropMock. And I'm going to remove the color. And you're in Visual Properties, go down to the very bottom, Visual Effects, and you can take it out right there. And if you need to match up the color, you can use your color selector. But if you're using a solid green color, it's going to work just about every time. But if it doesn't, you play with these right here, and then you can invert the effect just so where you can check it and make sure there's no diffusion coming around or it's picking up some other images. Like if on my coffee mug, to do a talking head on the coffee mug had about 30 different shades of green, so I had to play with these knobs a lot. But this is how you check your green screen right here. You should have two colors, black and green, when you do an inversion. Okay, so you could see through this. That's what the green screen does, is it cuts a hole in the in this image. And so you could see what's below it right here. Now I'm going to show what's below it. And then what you do here, I'm going to lock that one. What you do with this image is, again, you just, this is a actual video, and you go to your video properties. What I did was, I'm going to take this back to zero so you can see what it looks like normally. And it's normally up here. Normally it's at full animation here. There we go. So I just reset all the properties here. This just shows you how I'm starting out. And so the image itself looks like this. This is the video. And I've got to squeeze it down so it fits in this frame here. So that's what I'm going to do here. So I'm just going to start kind of getting it close. And now I want to tilt it one, about 1 degree there. And let's bring it a little bit closer here. Let's run the scrubber here. Okay, so I may want to just slide it over just slightly. Okay. Pull it back just a little bit there. And that's really all there is to create this little video. Then you would just save it. Go up to File, Save, and then Produce and Share. And normally I shoot everything at 1280 by 720, so I'll just go MP4 only to 720p. And then once you have it in a video, you can take it anywhere you want to go with it. But hopefully this helps. Again, what I did was, and I'm going to close that video. This video is mine. I made it with Content Samurai. But this video up here, and I'm going to turn off. Back to visual properties here. Just kind of reviewing here. Okay, there we go. This is with the... Okay, there we go. This is with the green screen on by hitting remove color. If I take it off, this is what I actually made in DropMock. And then all you do is just simply do this. And you can play with these knobs if you have a little bit of green coming out on your video. And then right here is, I just did a, that's what that image looked like. This is an image I actually made in DropMock. And I just did two animation keys on it. And then these images over here, I just did a duration of 1 second each and just rotated them. So it kind of gives it a cool effect. It looks like the dog is watching TV, so it visually attracts your attention, as dogs don't normally watch TV. And then coming over here, then I expand out that image and cover that up, and then I start my video story. So what I did this for is just strictly to get somebody's attention on Facebook. Dogs work. And moving objects work. Dogs work perfect on Facebook ads. So anyway, I hope this all helps. And I've got other products under VidPenguin Productions. And if you want to check out any more, or vidpenguin.com.